Well, I guess this is the end. We have reached the end of my 31 days of horror movie reviews, and I was trying to figure out what to do as far as what to review, what to watch. I kind of wanted it to be something that I've never seen before, but I also wanted it to be more Halloween themed than just flat out horror. And I settled on Boo! A Madea Halloween. This is my very first Madea movie ever. Holy crap, this did not disappoint, but in all of the bad ways possible. This was a 2016 film that was, of course, written, starring, directed, produced. Hell, he probably did the catering. He probably did security on set. Tyler Perry does it all in this movie, including playing multiple roles in the film. So the plot, really quick, is that we see Tyler Perry as this father who is trying to keep everything together with his kids on Halloween night. He has to go and do something. I think it's work-related. But honestly, at this point, I don't even remember what it was. And his daughter, specifically, she's 17, but she wants to go to a college party. Of course, he says no. And of course, she sneaks out and does it anyways. Now, he had asked his sister, once again played by Tyler Perry, as Madea, to watch the daughter. So you're following Madea, not only trying to keep this daughter in check, but dealing with a bunch of the frat college boys and their shenanigans, their scare tactics. This film is terrible. It is. This, I figured it would be bad, but I didn't quite know it would be this bad. Tyler Perry, all of his movies, like his non-Madea movies that I have seen, I feel like there's a certain level of directing with him that is at a subpar level. It's never quite great. It's never even all that good. It's maybe passable. Although, if you see certain other movies with editing and background characters, you might know that it's not really the greatest. But this, for sure, felt like a made-for-TV movie. And it'd be okay if it was, I guess, right? If this was on BET or what. But no, this was in theaters. Can you imagine paying full price to watch a movie that, in my opinion, was directed and put together so straightforward and lazily and just, man, there are certain shots, the blocking, just the way how characters are positioned in frame. I'm like, I would do a better job than this, and I don't direct professionally, you know? It's just, man, maybe it's because I went to school for it. I don't know. It was so in my face as far as the directing. But speaking of that, Tyler Perry as an actor is terrible. The one character in this movie where he's just playing a dad, he's playing a regular guy, he's playing arguably the most relatable person in this film. And he comes off as wooden. He comes off as generic. I know that the character is supposed to have a sort of, he can't quite control his daughter. He's a pushover. Everyone's walked all over him, including the mother and the daughter now. And so I get that there's a level of that, but I just mean his delivery isn't good. The opening scene when he's supposed to be trading trash talk with the fraternity guys, I half smirked and I almost laughed because I felt like some of the insults that he was trying to say to those college guys could have been funny, almost was funny. Like when he called the one guy Thor because he had long hair, and just he was saying certain things. He made fun of the fact of how all of these guys look like they're 60-something year old, which I would have said 30-something because at least it was more realistic. 60-something is just too over the top, and makes it not funny, but it's also his delivery of these lines that don't make it funny, that takes me out of the moment of actually maybe laughing. And now all I'm focusing on is just how bad his delivery is. Okay, so let's move away from Tyler Perry and just how bad of a job he did at acting and directing. Let's talk about this daughter. I believe her name's Tiffany. She is played by Diamond White. I'm sure that's her real government name. And I will say that I'm impressed that he actually casted a 17-year-old at the time to play a 17-year-old. So at least him making fun of how old-looking those college guys were, Tyler Perry stayed true to casting an actual teenager to play a teenager. And I'm not going to say really anything. I don't know what to say about her acting, per se. But her character is so unlikable. Again, the point. But she kind of goes over the top with how much of a bitch she is to her father. The talk back, I don't know. It's just like, I mean, I know that there are teenagers who do this, who do act like this. And so, yes, that's something that can be addressed. But I'm sitting there not caring what would happen to this daughter. And I don't know if I'm necessarily supposed to be feeling that way. Maybe if I connected more to Tyler Perry as a father, if I liked him and his character more, maybe that would be the balance, right? But now I'm in a situation where I don't care or like anybody on screen or involved with this plot. Like I said, you have Tyler Perry playing Madea, of course, like he does in all of his movies. I guess I just wasn't aware of how many characters he puts himself in. He's really trying to be the Eddie Murphy, or hell, even Marty McFly, when, you know, playing several different family members. Like, I get it, especially, it seems like this is probably based off of The Clumps in some way, where him playing every one of these characters is different. Madea is a very notable, over-the-top, and I can understand the likability of Madea. I can. I do. She's very abrasive. She's very in-your-face. She constantly talks about how she's had a past, you know, with God knows what, hooking or stripping. I don't really know. And she's making a lot of jokes, and she's very much like, this is how things are or should be. So I think if you're either a woman of the same age, or maybe if you're just somebody that enjoys this level of humor, I can understand maybe that appeal. I don't know. I found myself not really laughing at Madea. I wasn't as angry with the character like I was with the Tyler Perry father or the daughter. I sort of was just watching Madea. I was watching her be obnoxious. I was watching her be over the top. I get it. She's a memorable character for sure. I guess, you know, she's the character that people come here to see. This is true. But honestly, I thought the best character in this film was Tyler Perry as the grandfather, which is shocking because now here I am almost praising Tyler Perry for playing the grandfather character, because that character was over the top in the right way. Like, he wasn't an unbelievable character. He wasn't a character that I couldn't believe was a real person. He talked in a way, he said things to people in a way where it was quite amusing. And he made me break, because I was sitting there. Especially by the point when he shows up, it's over halfway through, and so I'm recognizing the idea that I'm just not going to be into this film. You know, I'm already kind of, my mind's made up. But he had a line where he said something to Tyler Perry, and he used the N-word, and just his delivery on how he did it actually broke me and actually made me laugh. Like, my one big laugh throughout the entire film. The one. So don't say I'm being too overly negative, because I did praise one aspect of it. Also, the acting all the way around is pretty bad. Like, all of the frat guys are terrible. They are. I don't think one of them was good acting-wise, delivery-wise. None of them just seem like real people. One actor, she played Tiffany's best friend. Addie, I think her name was. She's the girl who runs out of the fraternity because she reveals that she's 17. I guess nobody knew that these girls were 17. So there you go. Some of the other actresses that are in this film that were just there, honestly. Some of them more annoying than others. Cassie Davis played Bam. She's sort of Medea's right-hand woman, I guess. Her partner in crime who's with her the whole time. I don't know. There's something about this humor, something about these characters that I just wasn't really connecting. If I do watch any of the other Medea movies, I specifically hope that these side characters are involved. Like Hattie, I think her name is, played by Patrice Lovely. I mean, it was so over the top, her character. So goofy. So just, I wasn't feeling it. Bella Thorne is in this movie for one reason or another. I don't know why. I still don't fully get Bella Thorne's fame or notoriety, whatever you want to say about it. And yes, the Halloween aspect of it, I guess that could give you a reason to watch it around this time of year. I can't see myself ever watching this movie ever again, specifically because I didn't have as much fun. But at least it was Halloween themed. At least it did try to play into certain things that, you know, I'm sure somebody will find amusing. I'm sure, you know, these movies make money, don't they? Yeah, people, this wasn't the greatest Medea film to start off with, and maybe in retrospect, not the greatest movie to end my 31 Days of Horror on such a downer. But at least I tried, at least I gave it the old college try. Let me know in the comments below if you've seen Boo, a Medea Halloween. What do you think of it? Do you like it more than I do? Maybe you do think I was too harsh. Is the Medea films some of your favorite? Recommend which ones I should check out if you think I should. Man. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Later. Please won't you save my desires.